Hi everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Now we are going to discuss 25th question. So with this, I am going to finish 1/4 of the target. Out of 100 questions, 25th question. So what is the path of a charged particle in a region of uniform magnetic field? Nothing but it is all about motion of a charged particle in the presence of external magnetic field. Now, to understand the questions based on this, the very first thing is, what is the magnetic force on a moving charge in the presence of an external magnetic field? So that force is Q into V bar cross B bar. It is the cross product of V bar and B bar. So that means F bar direction perpendicular to V bar and B bar. And to understand this, I mean, if there is a charge Q entered in a magnetic field B with a speed V at some angle theta with the direction of magnetic field, then the magnetic force is QVB sin theta, theta 0 or 180 degrees, means parallel or anti-parallel, the magnetic force is 0, and theta 90 degrees means F is QVB, that is maximum. So this is the thing you need to understand first. Now sometimes what they will mention is, in a region where E bar and B bar both are present, then the force acting on the charge is, one is electrostatic force, another one is magnetostatic force, and the net force is called Lorentz force, that is Q into E bar plus V bar cross B bar. And sometimes they will give a condition that if charge goes undeflected. Undeflected means there is no shift in the position. Then E bar plus V bar cross V bar equal to 0. Then E equal to VB or V equal to E by B. This is the condition. Condition for no deflection. It continue to move with the in the same straight line along which it entered the region. So sometimes they will ask question about the combined region of electric and magnetic field. And then the question comes sometimes like, what is the direction of magnetic force? Now we can understand, to find direction we need to know Fleming left hand rule. Fleming left hand rule is, forefinger should be in the direction of B bar and middle finger should be in the direction of velocity, then thumb will give you the direction of F bar. Or else you can also use right hand thumb rule, like you have to rotate the right hand fingers from V bar to B bar, then the thumb will give you the direction of F bar, like screw rule or thumb rule. So this way, finding the direction is also important. Or else you can take V bar direction and B bar direction in terms of I cap and J cap, and if you take cross product, then also you will get the magnetic force direction. So depending on the question and depending on your understanding, you can follow any method, but you have to take care of finding magnetic force, because many times or most of the time they ask the question such that magnitude as well as direction. Now the question will be asked based on the same thing, that when there is a magnetic field. Let's take the magnetic field is B bar. Now, if charge entered, the charge Q entered with some velocity V bar, such that the angle between V bar and B bar is theta. Let's say like this angle is theta. Now, if theta equal to 0 degree or 180 degree, then force is 0, then it follows straight line path. It continue to move in the same direction, either along the magnetic field or in the opposite direction. That means either parallel or anti-parallel. Then comes the other one, that is theta equal to 90 degrees. When theta is 90 degrees, then the magnetic force is QVB, that is maximum. Then, in the presence of external magnetic field, it moves in a circular path. And the radius of the circular path is MV by QB. And the time to complete one revolution is 2 pi M by QB. Now, similar way, when theta is greater than 0 degrees and less than 90 degrees, then it moves in a helical path like this. Now, the horizontal distance covered in one rotation is called pitch. And here, the velocity will be at some angle theta with the B bar. Then we take two components, V cos theta and V sin theta, where V sin theta is V perpendicular that rotate the particle in circular path. V cos theta push the body forward so that it tries to move forward, and simultaneously it will try to cover circular path. So that here the radius is MV perpendicular by QB, means MV sin theta. And time period is same, 2 pi m by qb, and pitch equal to horizontal distance, that means horizontal velocity into time period. So this is the way the questions can be asked, or based on these formulas, questions can be asked. And sometimes they will also ask the question based on cyclotron. So it is a device, to accelerate charges to greater energies with the help of magnetic force. And here also same formulas will come, R equal to MV by QB, and the time period equal to 2 pi M by QB, and kinetic energy acquired is half mv square, where it is equal to half m into v is qb r by m whole square equal to q square b square r square by 2m. So they can ask question based on the cyclotron, but the formulas are similar, like the theta is 90 degrees. So that is what the thing, the basic idea we should have, basic formulas we should remember to solve the numericals based on this particular topic. Now let's see few examples based on whatever we have discussed. Now the very first thing is, a charged particle of specific charge, that is charge per unit mass, 0.2 coulomb per kg, has velocity 2i cap minus 3j cap. So velocity they have given as 2i cap minus 3j cap. In a magnetic field of uniform magnetic field, phi I plus 2j. Find the acceleration of the particle at this instant. Now, charge per unit mass means they have given charge by mass value, Q by M, that is 0.2 coulomb per kg. Then force equal to QVB sin theta, and here they have given in vector form. So we will write it as Q into V bar cross B bar, where F equal to MA equal to Q into magnitude of V bar cross B bar, then acceleration equal to q by m into magnitude of v bar cross b bar. How do you find the cross product of two vectors? You will take the determinant like I minus j k cap, and the second row should be coefficients of v bar, that is 2 minus 3 0, and third row is coefficients of v bar 5 2 0. And you know how to find the determinant of a matrix, and if you find it, you will get v bar cross b bar. Then you have to find the magnitude of v bar cross b bar. So in electrostatics as well as in magnetostatics, you need mathematics, you need vectors, especially lot of applications will come in finding the magnitude, in finding the direction of electric force or magnetic force. So you must learn vectors completely, then only you can solve questions based on electrodynamics, whether it is electrostatics or magnetostatics. Now one more question. What is the smallest value of B that can be set up at the equator to permit a proton of speed? So the speed of the proton is 10 power 7 meter per second to circulate around the earth. So what is the radius of the earth? 6.4 into 10 power 6 meter. Now what is the mass of the proton? 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg. Now it should circulate in the presence of earth magnetic field, means the radius should be equal to mv by qb. M is given, v is given, r and q. Charge of proton, nothing but e, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Then they are asking what value, the magnetic field value. So from this equation, B value will become mv by q into r, all the values given. Just substitute and calculate it, then you will get the answer. Next, sometime they will give comparison based question. A proton and alpha particle, usually they will ask between proton 1H1. So mass of proton, if you consider m, charge of proton is e. Then deuteron 1H2, that is mass of deuteron is 2 times, but charge of deuteron is same. And alpha particle 2 helium 4, mass of alpha particle is 4 times that of proton, but charge of alpha particle is 2 times. Now accelerated through same potential difference, enter in a region of uniform magnetic field with their velocities perpendicular to the field. Compare the radii of circular paths followed by them. Now radius equal to mv by qb. Now here they did not mention about velocity values. So then you have to manipulate the formula. Mv means linear momentum p by qb. But kinetic energy k equal to p square by 2m. Now p square equal to 2mk and p square equal to 2m. Kinetic energy is q into v. Because when a charge accelerated through a potential difference v, then the kinetic energy gain is qv. Then this value you need to substitute here. That is under root 2mqv by qv. That means 1 by v into under root 2mv by q. Now here, for proton and alpha particle, if you consider, they enter same region of uniform magnetic field. And proton and alpha particle mass is different. So r proportional to then root of m. And they accelerated through same potential difference, so same, divided by q. So r proton by r alpha particle means under root m proton by m alpha, and q alpha by q proton equal to m by 4m. It is 2e by e, so that it is 1 by root 2. So this way you can compare. Comparison based questions are important in almost every chapter. They can ask the comparison based question from any chapter based on any topic between two particles, between two situations. Now this way you can solve such questions. Now one more question. A beam of protons with velocity, so they have given velocity 4 × 10⁵ meter per second, enters in a region of magnetic field 0.3 tesla. The velocity makes an angle 60 degrees with the magnetic field. This is the angle between V bar and B bar. Then find the radius of the helical path taken by the proton beam and pitch. So radius of the helical path means MV perpendicular, nothing but V sin theta by QB, and pitch, P, pitch means V cos theta into T, where T is 2 pi m by QB. Now they have given all the values and they mentioned proton. So we know the mass of the proton. That is, mass of the proton is 1.627 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. So substitute all the values. Charges already we knew it. 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. So if you substitute the values, then you will get the answer. But after understanding the question, you need to realize that it is the third case, that is the case of helical path. And there, the radius is due to vertical component V sin theta and pitch is due to horizontal component V cos theta. That is what you need to understand. Now one last and final question. A charged particle having charge 2 coulomb is thrown with velocity inside a region of E bar and magnetic field. The largest force acting on the particle. Now they have given V bar. So 2i plus 3j. And also E bar, that is 2j cap. And also B bar, that is 5k cap. Now first you need to find V bar cross B bar. As I said, I minus j k. V bar means 2, 3 and 0. And V bar is 0, 0, 5. Only k cap is there. Then if you find it, then you will get the V bar cross B bar value. Then charge value they are given as charge is 2 coulomb. Then what is the Lorentz force formula? FL bar equal to Q into E bar plus Q into V bar cross B bar. So this way you can find it. And E bar given, V bar cross B bar, you will find it. Like here if you find I coefficient means the row and column linked with I will get cancelled. So 3 × 5 = 15 − 0. And minus J, J component means 10 − 0, and K coefficient will become 0. So that 15 i cap − 10 j cap will come. Now that if you substitute here, you will get the answer. This is how you need to deal with the motion of charged particle in the uniform magnetic field, sometimes in the combined region of electric and magnetic field, where you need to know basically about what is the magnetic force and how to find the direction when a charge q entered in a magnetic field with a velocity v bar. And as usual, I have given the assignment questions based on the same thing. So try to solve all the questions. And also I have given numericals based on the same topic from the NCERT. Based on this topic also, they have given lot of questions, around 6 or 7 questions are there. So please try to understand all the questions and try to solve them. So thank you all of you. We'll continue in the next session with the next topic. Thank you all of you.